quantum theory.
Space-time.
How did we get to here? To a place that is so incredibly confusing.
A variant of myself lived on Earth in the 31st century.
This past season of Loki is just one stage in Marvel's long flirtation with the idea of the multiverse, and it's going to become a full-on love affair in the next few years. So I have a question.
What are you so afraid of?
No, my question is, how did we get to this being mainstream? How did the largest, most mainstream cultural touchstone, the company that gave us, like, Donald Duck, end up putting all its weight behind such a bizarre theoretical concept as the multiverse? But it is not just Marvel. We're talking about the DC multiverse, the Spider-Verse, all the other verses. So with that said, I present to you a very brief cultural history of the multiverse. This is not going to be any of the science stuff, except where the science stuff affects the culture. This is the stuff in the cultural ether. Let's define the multiverse. Oh, are we doing a multiverse thing? Yeah, I guess so. Oh, I love it. So are you an alternate Phil who knows how to experience the human emotion called happiness? Oh, you're so sweet. Yes. Back to the definition. The multiverse, as we're talking about it, is a network of connected alternate realities that are often used to explore character or historical arcs that differ from the ones that we know on Earth or in primary stories. Spider-Verse, please provide some exposition.
Are you from another dimension? Like a parallel universe where things are like this universe but different? And you're Spider-Man in that universe? But somehow traveled to this universe, but you don't know how?
Wow, that was really just a guess?
Well, we learned about it in physics.
That makes a lot of sense. I like cars. Cars go fast. Okay, what are you? The fire engine goes fast. It has a siren, goes wee-oo, wee-oo. It puts out the fire. Are you the variant of Phil that has the interests of a three-year-old? Yes, a three-year-old. I like trucks. Oh. I like this guy. This multiverse has clear narrative possibilities, and sketching out its broad history is kind of important to understanding it. I think you can stand to go back to the universal monsters in fiction, establishing this idea of a shared universe in which Dracula, Frankenstein, the Invisible Man, and the Wolfman sort of interact in bad films and get inauspiciously rebooted in worse ones. That is not a multiverse. Can I have a cookie? Oh snap! Oh snap? Are you on his side?
He needs encouragement.
Okay, yes, it is not a multiverse, but it shows the intellectual property opportunities and limitations of a shared universe. The multiverse that we have is kind of the best of both worlds, and for that, we've got to go to Hugh Everett. Hugh Everett III was born in 1930. I don't trust my explanation, so here is Devs with a little more exposition. This great show is probably the one that delved the most fully into the Everett interpretation of quantum mechanics, though a lot of other shows have done it implicitly.
Everett, whose interpretation states that there is no change to the superposition of the humble quantum particle. Rather, there is a change to the entire universe.
It states that the macroscopic superposition exists.
And just so we're all clear what that means, it means the universe is constantly splitting, like the trunk and branches and twigs of an infinitely large tree. And on that tree, all possible worlds will exist. All possible events will happen, all histories and all futures, a near infinite number of times.
This is the mini worlds theory. And it is the poppy underpinning for our multiverse. Can I have raisins now? I like raisins. Do you see it? This kind of fine book right here is actually pretty important. Not because of its influence, but because it represents a turning point in the way that we think about the multiverse. That's because it's in a 1970 review for this book that the word multiverse first appeared in the New York Times. There were other, older uses of the word, but they were really different, more philosophical. I'm not trying to credit this book, Counterparts by Tom Baum. Tom Baum. But I am saying that it represents a turning point. In comics, we had already seen multiple worlds, but they were kind of infested with a weird flavor. Not the scientific weirdness of Hugh Everett. It's about this guy, William Keniston, who meets different versions of himself. Some are pretty normal, but have different jobs or different haircuts, and some are super weird. Here's one Keniston yelling at another. It isn't the future or the past. It's the present, I swear to God. Why couldn't time divide? It did, I swear. Only it got stuck or something, with passages. So this is the idea of time dividing, a la Everett in many worlds, and there being passages between these different universes, which is how multiverses pretty much work today. There are parts in this book that connect directly to the multiverse plot points that have happened in Loki and Spider-Verse.
This could literally not get any weirder.
It can get weirder. I just washed my hands, that's why they're wet.
In this book, he meets different versions of himself that have freaky claw hands or lobster legs. And in this season of Loki, Loki falls in love with a variant of himself. That happens right here. William Keniston hooks up with Billy Keniston, who he says is super beautiful. I would have said spoiler alert, but you're not going to read this book. Are you saying that they all ripped off this book? This book isn't a landmark, but it is a signpost. One that pointed to Everett's many worlds interpretation as one with narrative possibilities that flowed from a hip scientific theory. From this point on, the multiverse continued to ripple through the culture as a sci-fi curio, like in the quantum multiverse of 1995's Sliders.
Quinn Mallory just unlocked the gateway to an alternate universe.
Sliders is brought to you by Mentos, the fresh maker.
I love Mentos, the fresh maker. Then, finally, Marvel got in the mix. They had already been kind of retconning Jack Kirby's psychedelic cosmic weirdness with more scientifically infused plot points.
That looks like a collapsing neutron star inside of an Einstein-Rosen bridge.
The mini-worlds multiverse was perfect for Doctor Strange and Spider-Man and Ant-Man, who already had the quantum realm, to come together. Now it all seems obvious, but let's not lose sight of how incredibly weird it is that we live in a universe where the multiverse is the stuff of underwear and Happy Meals. I have underwear. I have underwear. Me too, little Phil. Me too. All right, thank you so much for watching. If you haven't been to this channel before, I do personal and history videos. This one is just, you really thought you could do it, didn't you? You really thought you could make a video without me? Circle Glasses Phil is the one true variant. The variant that controls them all. Oh, I will return.